Hey, it's Dan. You know, as we deliver this, it's the last day of November 2021, which is really, really hard to believe. And we're about ready to roll into December. And you may have heard on the news or seen articles online about sort of the December drop, right? That sales are starting to drop, prices are starting to drop, and it's going to get worse in December. There have been economists online quoted as saying prices are dropping in 2022. I just got an article from a group called Inman News, which is one of the kind of the most prolific providers of real estate information to the real estate industry, with a statement that said Fannie Mae, one of the biggest backers of mortgages in the country, Fannie Mae says prices and sales are going to drop between now all the way through the end of 2023. Well, it was cause for concern. It caught my attention. Well, as you may have picked up on here in the last few years, regarding anything we see in the news, especially online, sometimes the content of the article does not match the headline of the article, as is the case for those where you're seeing prominent economists and so forth suggesting we're about to hit a big sales and pricing drop. Okay, so there's two things to look at. First of all, let's just talk about, are sales going to drop in December? Yes. As you can see, every year they drop in December. In the last 3 years, there's been a general trend to see fewer sales between September and December, a couple of peaks in October. But the idea is we're going to see drops throughout the throughout the winter. That's not a sign of anything. That's not a sign the market's dropping out from under our feet. The number of sales decreases every winter. Why? Well, there's a few things. The holidays are an obvious one, but there's also fewer people who want their house on the market during the winter for a variety of reasons that have nothing to do with market conditions. They have to do with weather conditions. Some homes have an awful lot of outdoor space that you should go take a look at as a buyer, and they don't look good during the winter, so people don't put them on the market. There's a lot of houses where to go enjoy it and see it outside, you're going to get dirty, and they don't want people going out getting dirty and coming back into the house, so they don't go to the market in the winter. The house is only light, it's only light outside around the house until about 4 to 5 o'clock during this time of year. Some people think, no, I want my house visible for 4, 5, 6, and 7 o'clock showings with the light still on outside. So the sun being out. In any event, there's a lot of reasons why people don't do it this time of year that, again, have nothing to do with the market going up or the market going down. So are the number of sales going to go down in December? Yep, almost certainly they are. Will the number of houses hitting the market go down over the next 30 and 40 days? Yep, almost certainly they will, because it's the time of year. So if you're worried about long-term real estate trends, fine, reach out and we can talk about those. But understand that for the month of December, we expect things to slow down a little. Doesn't mean there's no opportunity. Doesn't mean there aren't plenty of buyers out still trying to find a place. That's still going to continue to be pretty hot for the next month. But we are going to see fewer people involved on both ends. So that's number one. When you hear about the December drop in sales, it happens every year. When the market was doing this in 2020, we had fewer sales in December. So don't get too caught up in that kind of stuff that they put out on a lot of the headlines. The second, if you see things about prices expected to drop again in December, prices expected to drop in 2022 and into 2023, like the article I got that said Fannie Mae calls for it, understand that those headlines are often misleading, as I mentioned, because what's in the article is that price appreciation rates are expected to drop. Across the country, and certainly here in the Portland area, we've gotten accustomed for the last year or so, year and a half, to appreciation rates of greater than 10%. That's not historically common. That's certainly not sustainable. So yes, appreciation rates are going to go down. So for the headline purpose, if someone says, well, it was 10% 1 year and 9% the next, and then 8%, 7%, 6%, 5%, you get the idea. You could argue, well, look, they may say prices have been going down for the last 6 years. But that's not true. You and I know that. We're smarter than that. The price growth has gone down each year. But price growth going down is not the same thing as prices going down. There still are no widespread suggestions that we're going to see prices go down in the next year or two. But the rate of growth is going to go down. It has to. As we've talked about, these 13, 14, 15, 20% appreciation rates can't last. So if you see a lot of headlines that look pretty interesting or frightening about the December drop, remember, that's their job, is to make interesting headlines. So you'll click, make them a few shekels, and then your article opens up. Take a read through it. Prices aren't going to drop in December. but the rate of appreciation is going to continue to mellow out a little. If you have any specific questions about your part of town, whether you're in Portland proper or here in the suburbs, reach out and let me know, and we'll get you an updated valuation for your property so you can see what's really going on in the market for your house, your neighborhood, your part of town. Thanks again. Welcome to the last day of November. We hope you're enjoying the holidays and are gearing up for the heart of the season. Talk to you soon.